In this screencast, we're going to look at how to use the code formatting features in IntelliJ IDEA. Generally, we'll find while coding that we don't need to manually format our code. IntelliJ IDEA does its best to do the right thing automatically. For example, if we press Enter, the caret goes into the correct place for us to start typing. The same applies if we use other shortcuts, including using live templates or code generation. Even if we take some code that is inconsistently formatted, copy it, and paste it into the editor, IntelliJ IDEA will format this code to the project standards. However, if we do have code that doesn't meet the project standards, we can ask IntelliJ IDEA to format it. We could highlight a specific piece of code and press Alt, Command, and L, or Control, Alt, and L on Windows and Linux, to format just the highlighted code. Or we can use the same shortcut without selecting the code, and the whole file will be reformatted. We also get a helpful balloon saying what the formatter did. What happens if the code formatter didn't do what we expected? For example, here, we might have expected the formatter to add curly braces around our if statement. But when we format the code, it stays as it was. We can go into the preferences and set our expected standards. In Editor, Code Style, and in this case Java, we'll see all the formatting options. The project is currently using the IDE's default code style. We can duplicate these settings and give it a useful name. Now, when we change the settings, they'll be saved to this scheme. We're interested specifically in the braces in our code, particularly for if statements. We can force if statements to always have curly braces. The preview on the right shows what selecting this setting will do to the code, so we can experiment with these settings to see which one we want. Now we can save these settings, and they'll be saved to the scheme. Now, when we reformat our selected code, IntelliJ IDEA automatically inserts curly braces according to our style. We saw that there are a lot of code style settings to potentially look through and change. There is a simpler way if we have a section of code that we know needs reformatting differently. If we want for loops to also have curly braces, we can highlight an example of the code we want to change the formatting of and press Alt and Enter. Then we select Adjust Code Style Settings. IntelliJ IDEA will show just the settings that apply to this bit of code. We can experiment with these settings and see the changes previewed live in our code. Under the Wrapping and Braces tab, we can set Force Braces to Always to have IntelliJ IDEA insert curly braces around the body of our for loop. We could choose to reformat the whole file once these changes have been saved, but we don't need to do this since we've selected the only for loop in this class. Often, we don't want to reformat the whole file that we're working on, particularly if this is a system with inconsistent formatting and we don't want to commit a lot of whitespace changes as well as our feature or bug fix. If we were working on a file with some inconsistently formatted code like this one, but we had only changed the method below it, running reformat code might change parts of the file we haven't touched, as well as our actual changes. Let's undo this, as that's not what we wanted. We could highlight the code we've changed and just reformat that, but that won't work if our changes are scattered throughout the file. Let's undo this too. There's a better way. We can use Alt, Shift, Command, and L, or Control, Alt, Shift, and L on Windows, to bring up the reformatting options. Now we can say we only want to format the lines of the file that have been changed and leave everything else alone. Now, when the file is formatted, it only changes the lines that we've touched and not the other inconsistently formatted code. Before we go further, I want to show a specific formatting setting to use with Java 8 streams. So let's convert this code to use the Streams API. Currently, the code style settings allow the chained method calls on the Streams API to stay on the same line, making an extremely long line of code, and trying to reformat this code has no effect. Let's use Alt and Enter to see which settings we can change for this code. We want to change the wrapping settings, and we're interested in the wrapping of chained method calls. We can try out these different settings to see which combination we want. I like each of my stream operations on a different line. I find it helps readability. This is a good first step towards what I want, but I want the dots to all line up vertically. To do this, we need to go into our code style settings. We can search for the word align, look in wrapping and braces, and find chained method calls. If we select align when multiline, the preview shows us this is what we wanted. We can save this change to the code style settings. And then, when we reformat the file, the stream operations are all aligned the way I wanted. These formatting settings are stored in a settings file in the project's .idea folder. IntelliJ IDEA also supports using an editor config file to define the code style. Let's create a new editor config file. This will be our root. And let's add the standard editor config properties and IntelliJ IDEA specific settings for Java code. IntelliJ IDEA populates this file with all the settings that we've already defined in our code style. These properties are split into those which apply to all files and those which apply only to Java files. Anything with an IJ prefix is a setting specific to IntelliJ. If we look through all these settings, we can see the ones we've just defined for our Java 8 streams, that we want chained method calls to be wrapped with one operation on each line. In fact, if we go back to our stream method call code, we can copy this and then paste it into the preview panel for the editor config. Then we can see what happens to our code when we make changes to the editor config properties. As you'd expect from IntelliJ IDEA, we get code suggestions if we use the code completion shortcut. Let's turn off the chained method calls wrapping. And if we also turn off keep line breaks, the preview shows us this will mean our stream call is put back into a single line. If we go back to our code and reformat it, we can see IntelliJ IDEA uses the new editor config settings to format the changed lines in the file. Note that our editor config settings are used instead of the settings we defined in our Java code style preferences, which still has our old settings for chained method calls. If we look at the code style settings, we can see that editor config support is enabled and that this setting warns us the editor config file settings may override the IDE settings. One of the advantages of using an editor config file is that we can define a file for each directory. This is useful if we have different code settings for test code and production code, or if a legacy part of the codebase has a different style. Let's say we want to define different Java settings for this directory. Once again, IntelliJ IDEA populates this generated file with the settings we defined in the IDE settings. But IntelliJ IDEA has detected that most of these settings were already defined in our first editor config, which is the parent for this file, and therefore we don't need to repeat all of those again in this file. Let's get IntelliJ IDEA to remove all the duplicates, so we can see which settings are different for this directory. Now we can see that this file has our chained method calls settings from the IDE. If we go back to our code, which uses the Streams API, and reformat it, now it uses the settings from this directory's editor config to format the code. In fact, if we go to the bottom right of the IDE, we can see it's using an editor config to format the file. We can click on this and see which file we're using. One last thing on the editor config file. It supports code completion for property names and values, so we can use Control and Space to bring up suggestions. As usual, we can start typing something we're looking for, and the suggestions will be narrowed down. We've seen how to reformat our code, how to change the settings for the formatter, including using an editor config file to store the settings, and how reformatting can even do small code changes like adding braces. Let's look now at one of the options mentioned in the Reformat File settings, Rearrange Code. Let's open a class with a lot of methods and fields declared in it. This class has fields, setters, getters, and other standard methods, all scattered throughout the file. We can use find action and start typing rearrange to find the rearrange code action. When we select this, IntelliJ IDEA will reorder the code of this class according to the settings for the project, which in this case are the default settings for the IDE. We can see all the fields are placed at the top of the file, and the getters and setters for a field are placed next to each other. This definitely helps to see at a glance what's included in the state of an instance of this class. However, we might want to go further in organizing the code in a class. For example, we might want to put private methods to the bottom of the class underneath all the public ones. Let's open up preferences to change our settings. Once again, we need to be in code style, Java, but this time we need to look under the arrangement tab. We can see there are some standard rules which can be turned on or off, like keeping the getters and setters together. The bottom section shows all the rules for arranging the file. Fields will be ordered according to the modifiers that apply to them, and they'll always be at the top of the file. Initializers and constructors will come after the fields. Methods come after that, and if there are any inner enums, interfaces or classes, they'll be put at the bottom of the file. Let's change the existing method rule to apply to public methods and add a new rule for methods that are private. Note that these rules state the public methods should appear above the private methods. We could use find action to rearrange the file, or reformat the file and tick the rearrange code option. But we can also use search everywhere, which we can bring up by pressing shift twice. And then when we type rearrange, we can see all the files and actions that match this. Once we've called rearrange code, we'll see that our private method has been moved to the bottom of the file underneath all the public methods. IntelliJ IDEA offers a lot of automation and configuration to let us define exactly how our files should be formatted, and we can even define the order things appear in our code files. This lets us define a consistent style for our project code and encourages us to write code that's consistent with the rest of our team. Thanks for watching.